Hi guys, how's it going today? I just wanted to do a quick tutorial just to go over how you can stream your Xbox One games to YouTube and you don't even need a capture card. All you're going to need to stream your Xbox One to YouTube is a Windows 10 PC, the Xbox desktop app. You're going to need encoding software and a YouTube account. A good open source encoder that I recommend, and it's the one that I use, is the OBS Project. They're really good. It's pretty easy to set up. They have a lot of tutorials that can help you learn how to use it, and it's free, so you can't beat that. But if you would prefer to pay for software, something that might have more features or is easier to use out of the box, you can always check out YouTube's support page, and they have other options there, and they have recommendations. Plus, on their support page, they have tutorials as well that can help you optimize your stream. So the basic way that this is going to work is your Xbox is going to utilize the streaming mode. You're going to stream to your PC, and then from your PC, you stream to OBS Studio, your encoder, and then your encoder will stream your gameplay up to YouTube. So it's you know, there's a couple steps. So basically you need that Xbox app that should already be on your Windows 10 PC, and then once you go into there, you'll see you can enable game streaming. So you're just going to go boop, click stream. You can test it first just to make sure there's nothing, you know, that you can make sure your network quality and stuff is good. So this is what OBS Studio is going to look like once you are, you know, once you have it all set up properly and you have it streaming. So you can use game capture or you can use desktop capture, but I'm going to go over this in, you know, a lot more detail. Then your next step is to get that little, you know, that middle piece, that that open source software. You need the encoder in order to get your game stream up to YouTube. So you can go to the Open Broadcaster site and you can download it straight from here. I'll put a link in the description so you guys know how to get here and download that. So you just download that, and then you get that running, and then I can show you now how to set it up. So we're just going to go into OBS. So right now I have it set up with display capture, but we're going to actually use game capture. You can use either one, but game capture is a little nicer, because when say you're streaming and then you want to open up your browser or something or check Facebook, you don't really want to stream that out. And if you're not thinking, you might not even realize that you just are broadcasting all your personal stuff. So you can stop your stream or, you know, pause the stream. But better just to use the game capture mode, which you can see right here. I can show you how to set that up. So you go to game capture, and then you're going to want to, here, if you just leave it at capture any full screen application, it's not going to work. You have to go to capture a specific window, and then from there you have to pick which one you want. So we're gonna pick Xbox. It's xboxapp.exe, and then here you're gonna wanna match title, otherwise find a window of the same executable. I also think match title, otherwise find a window of the same type works as well, but I just go with the same executable. And that seemed to work for me. Then you just have to make sure you got your audio set up, you know, however you want your volume. You may have to go into settings and then set up your audio to make sure that your mic is coming through. So you can just put it to default, because I think out of the box it's actually disabled. Your audio should already be enabled. If it's not, you can go in here and you can set that. You're going to want to change your sample rate to 44.1 kilohertz. And then everything else there should already be okay out of the box. Next, you're going to want to go to video. It depends on what resolution you want. You can go up to, you know, you can do 1280 by 720, or you can do 1080p if your PC is able to stream it. The games are usually, you know, a lot of these Xbox games are in 720p anyways. I leave it at 720. Plus, it's a little less work on the PC, and my like I was saying before, my PC is not the highest end PC in the world, so that's what I do. But you can always bump that up if you want to. Now for output, I like to use advanced mode, and then for my encoder I use this X264. It's the only encoder option I'm that I'm given for this PC, but other, depending on your graphics card, you'll have different options there. So you might have to go to OBS and you'll have to find a forum there if you have, you know, if you need to try some other options in there. Xbox prefers rate control to be set at the CBR. I'm using a bit rate of 1800 right now for my streams, but I can definitely bump that up. Out of the box, they have it set at 2500. That's usually fine. Keyframe interval for streaming to YouTube is supposed to be at 2. I have my CPU preset at ultra fast. Now, this is what controls the quality of your video, but it's also dependent on how powerful your PC is. Mine isn't very powerful, so I have to bump mine all the way up to ultra fast, otherwise I start getting lagging and it just crashes. Profile set it to main tune. I have it set at fast decode. Most people, I think, just put it to none. Under audio, set your audio bitrate to 128. Your stream, you're gonna go onto when you go onto YouTube to set up your live stream, you're gonna get a stream key there, and that's you're gonna enter it in here. And then you'll save all that stuff. I think that's all the general stuff. I leave everything else basically default. Under advanced, you can set this too high or above normal. I put it at above normal because I think it takes too much resources away from the PC in order for it to do the streaming in your local network from your Xbox. So I usually set it at above normal so it's not overtaking the processes from the Xbox app itself. If I had a capture card, I'd probably set it to high. And then everything else here, I'm pretty sure I leave at default except for I do a 2 second stream delay. It seems to help a little bit for the quality of my streams. That helps me a little bit because of how crummy my PC is. That's everything in the settings. So once you got everything set up, you'll hit start streaming, and then you'll go out to YouTube, and in there under the control panel, you'll get to preview your stream and test out your stream first before you start it if you're setting up as a live event. It's pretty simple. You can stream to YouTube without a capture card. Now that we have our Xbox app and also our encoder all set up, we can navigate out to YouTube and we can get started setting up our event or a live stream. To get there, you go to Creator Studio, and from there you're gonna navigate over to the live streaming tab and then to events. And then from there you can input your title, your description, your keywords, all that stuff, a thumbnail, and you can start streaming your event from there. It's going to end up, there's encoder settings in there as well. You'll have to set up your resolution, things of that sort. It's pretty simple, step by step, just take your time, and then you can preview your stream and you can get started. So once you have your encoder set up, you have your live stream set up on YouTube, and everything's all good to go there. You can go out to your game in the Xbox app, start the game obviously on Xbox, and start streaming that over to your PC. And do that, you just come down to this tab here in the Xbox app, and you go right here, go to stream. And then this always pops up. There are no controllers attached to your PC. It always says that even if it's attached to my PC for some reason, I'm not sure why. I just click continue. I mean, because in this setup, you can plug up, as you probably already know, if you know about the streaming feature, you can, with USB, plug one into your PC, or you can just leave it plugged into your Xbox One, or not even plugged in, wireless, whatever. So I just hit continue, and then you can start streaming your game, doing your commentary, everything else. This is Skate 3. They just had a big update. This game is sweet. And this is one I think I'm going to stream today. It's been great. Duffed it. So that's it, guys. Let me know how it goes. If you have any suggestions of ways that I could improve this tutorial, if there's anything I missed, definitely let me know in the comments, and I'll make sure I get that either edited or do another video on things that you guys need clarification on if you have any trouble. So thanks for watching. Definitely subscribe and like if you like this, or if you want to see more streams like this, and also check out my other videos. All right, have a great